In the metal squadrons today, copper actually goes up 1.1%. It's now up two consecutive days. Not a very big move overall, but still a little bit of hope there. And there's some hope overall in the markets for copper as you look back to March 19th when we put in a low of 197.95 on the July copper contract. It's rallied 17.8% since then. So we're getting a little bit of strength out of copper, even though over the last 2 weeks or so, it's been pretty much sideways in terms of its movement. The recovery hopes are driving copper. There's the hopes that a global recovery has begun as the numbers and the pandemic start to get a little bit better, states in the U.S. starting to reopen, and hopefully that U.S.-China trade tension doesn't really pan out from a broader perspective. There has been some requests for tariff exemptions to be extended. There hasn't been a negative reaction to those requests yet. So overall, it looks like pretty positive for base metals, and copper, of course, one of the biggest base metals out there, especially in terms of their use in China, China being the largest consumer of copper. Now you look towards China, and we do have Chinese data coming out tomorrow. Vacation PMI, manufacturing services, and composite are all due out tomorrow, along with the balance of trade. Now the balance of trade is expected to have fallen quite a bit, by more than half of what it was in its last iteration. But that balance of trade number, along with a potentially strong PMI from the Iaccino index, could come out and push copper a little bit higher to finally break out of its recent range. But again, that move in copper since those lows, and those lows we posted at 197.95 were lows going all the way back to 2016. That move has been 17.8% higher. We've seen 2 days up now consecutively.